Okay, maybe this isn't the best decision I've made this week. I don't know what I was thinking. Apparently I wasn't. Hey, that's my plant. And that's an anthill. You sit on that anthill and you're going to have a really bad day. I don't know what, well, he's going to have a really bad day. I don't know what I was thinking. Actually, I guess I wasn't thinking. I've been getting so many things in the mail and I have such limited garden space right now. I'm actually kind of guerrilla gardening all over my yard. A friend sent me some pepper plants, some tomato plants, some, that's, you're on the plant. Okay, sent me so many plants. I didn't know where to put them. I didn't have any room in the plowed garden, and so I was just digging holes. I had tomatoes, I had eggplants, I had peppers. So I was putting them in the garden, I was putting them outside the garden, and I ran out of space, and finally I just took the shovel and came out here out in the middle of the yard and dug a hole, opened it up, shoved the pepper plant in there, closed the hole, watered it, and walked away and called it a day. Thing is it started growing. Yeah, the darn thing started growing. Problem is, I probably didn't pick the best space because there's an anthill right here, which means I can't really hang out for very long. Otherwise, nature's little minions are gonna start crawling up my leg, and that can't be good. But they're doing good. I have 1, 2, 3, where's the fourth one? Oh, the fourth one's over there. And I got those, and I got Rascal sitting on the third one. And then, remember, by the way, before I get going, people that are friends on my Facebook, my Facebook page kind of, I don't know what's going on, and so let me explain. Okay, really quick. I have a Facebook page, and some viewers like to connect with me personally, more so than on the video, so I have a Facebook page, and you can join me over there if you want. It's open to everybody. As long as you join in, because if you're not going to join in, why would you want to connect over there? Anyway, I have a Facebook page, and I had 5,000 friends. That's as many friends as you can have on a personal Facebook page, and that's a lot of friends. Problem is that I couldn't go any higher, so people that wanted to be friends over there, they had to wait. And it was like a waiting list, and I felt kind of bad because I couldn't add new friends because I was full. And I thought, well, that's kind of sad. I don't ever want to be the kind of person that focuses on numbers and has this mess going on. So what I did was, I thought, well, let's make it so that everybody can be in here. No waiting list. That way it's not like this velvet rope thing where you wait to get into the club. I opened it up and turned it into a regular Facebook page, and instantly I had hundreds more friends. Only problem is I didn't like the look of the page. It looked too, I don't know, tacky, impersonal. You know, you've seen those kind of pages. Yeah, I don't like that. So what I did was I shut it down. Yep, 5,000 friends down the tube. And I opened up a new page. Yeah, I have a new personal YouTube page, and it's small, it's cozy, it's exactly what I wanted. And the people from the old page are coming over there and migrating to the new page. If you want to join me on Facebook, if you want to join me, I do this, I feel like John Kohler. If you want to join me on Facebook, there's a link below this video. Click on that, go there, send a friend request, and everybody's welcome. So now that I've said that, I'm going to start griping. Michigan Bulb Company, a really sucky company, I ordered from them, and I don't know, I just assumed that they would send me something decent. I ordered strawberries and asparagus. Problem is, they sent me crap. Yeah, they sent me these little tiny strawberry roots that really, I don't know what they were thinking. It's just like they culled the worst of the worst and tossed them in a bag. And I planted them. I thought, they're garbage. And that spurred this other guy named Ray to send me all kinds of asparagus roots. And now I'm up to my ears in asparagus. I sent an email to Michigan Bulb Company because I believe if you're in business, you should do the best that you can for your customers. Phoning it in is not my idea of acceptable business. I was a businessman for many years, and I did my best to give my customers the best that I possibly could for their dollar, because they work. They work just like you and me. And we don't like going to our jobs sometimes. We don't like sitting behind a desk. We don't like working outside all day long, working up a sweat, being away from our family. But we get paid for it. And that's what we work, we earn our money, we pay our dues, and we want our money's worth. And so I ordered from Michigan Bulb Company, and I used my money. And they sent me crap. So I sent them an email. I wasn't asking for my money back, and I wasn't asking for replacements. I just wanted them to know that I knew that the stuff they sent me was garbage and I didn't appreciate that. I don't care if it's cheap or not. If you want to send me garbage, put it on there, garbage, and that way I'll be able to make an intelligent decision as a customer. So they sent me garbage, and I sent them an email telling them what garbage they had. So what do? They send me more garbage. You know, I'm thinking, if this was a restaurant, it would be so hilariously funny. I mean, I'd go into a restaurant and there's a fly in my soup, and I'd tell the waiter, hey, there's a fly in my soup. And so what does he do? He brings me another bowl of soup with a fly in it. I don't know what I'm going to do. So now I got more roots, and there's a fight going on with some birds over there. Anyway, so I got two more bags of strawberry roots. Like, I really need more strawberry roots. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm just going to plant them all over the place. I just thought I'd mention that because I thought it was actually kind of funny. Even though it was stupid, it's kind of funny. I'm gardening today, but I wanted you to join me in the garden because there's some new stuff going on. Yep. Last episode, I told you I was going to show you all the new stuff that's strange things that are growing here. I changed my mind. I do that. I want to show you what's coming up in the garden because I have to actually be in the garden. So I figured, what the heck? You're not doing anything. Might as well join me in the garden. Take a look at what happened in the last few days. Hi there. There's a robin nest up in this elm tree above my head. And so she comes out. I wish my microphone would pick it up. Listen. Hear that? Yeah, that's Mama Robin. Yeah, she's not very happy with me. And neither are these ants. Let's go to the garden before I get eaten alive. Watch out. There's bees on that hose. You sit on the... Oh, your butt is going to have a bad day, rascal. This is my garden. Yep. And it now has fencing. Yes, it does. I put some little tiny metal posts in, and I ran some fencing around here. This fencing is about maybe, 2x2, and that keeps the rabbits out. Yeah, some people may say, well, rabbits won't stay out of there. They'll crawl right through. Well, you haven't seen the rabbits in Iowa. These big-headed GMO monsters cannot get through this fencing, guaranteed, I can tell you, unless they're baby rabbits and there are none. Anyway, I put this around here, and the first night that I had this up, I felt kind of, you know, self-satisfied. Hey, I put up a fence and I'm going to keep all the varmints out. Deer walked through my garden, and deer, you know, those long-legged herbivores just went tut, 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 right through my garden. So I had to put up more fencing. Yes, I put in these huge T-posts, and these are the big iron ones that you have to hit them with a sledgehammer. Yep, I put these in, and I cannibalized some of this fencing from around my property, this old fencing, and I put it up here from the top of this all the way up, you know, about maybe chest height. So in case, well, the deer could jump over that, but you know, they're not really that hungry. I got clover and everything else growing out here. They really don't need what I'm growing. So I got this all the way around the garden, but I have this area right here where I can just walk over it and the deer don't come over here. So that explains the fencing, in case anybody's going to ask, because no matter what I film, somebody always asks me a question of what I didn't talk about. So I want to make sure I talk about as much as possible. Okay, fencing. Take a look at what I have over here. Oh, make sure I don't fall. Yeah. Aha! Beans. Yes! These are my beans. Remember in a couple episodes back, I showed you how I keep these protected from frost by bringing in the grass. The grass has worked fantastic. It's rained a couple times, and when I peel this back, it's beautiful. The grass keeps all of this moist. It's keeping the weeds down, which I think is fantastic, and the worms will come up here and start feeding on this. If you have a lawn, some gardeners will tell you, lawns are a waste of money and you should plant food instead of lawns. I don't subscribe to that, okay? I never have. I'm not trying to be different. I just never have subscribed to that way of thinking. In my opinion and in my practice, I use my lawn to help feed myself. Yeah, my lawn is functional. I have acres of it. But what I do, even if I lived in the city, I mow my lawn. And I bring my grass into the compost pile and I make compost out of it. The compost feeds my soil. My soil feeds my plants. My plants feed me and they feed my chickens. And my chickens eating the excess garden of produce and the excess grass from the lawn, they lay eggs and the eggs feed me. So my lawn is actually a working partner in my garden. And that's where I think the two-dimensional thinking of some gardeners really doesn't serve us well. You can do so many different things if you stop looking so narrowly down the path and start thinking a little differently. You know, and that's where I think I'm a little bit different, is that my lawn, yes, I could grow food out there, but you know what? I don't need 3 acres of food, and I don't want to grow 3 acres of food to give to the food banks. I'm here to grow food for myself. That's what I do. It may seem selfish, but you know what? I'm okay with that. I raise my grass, I mow it, and I'm going to start putting it in my aisles here. And what will happen is this will feed the worms. The worms will feed the soil, aerate the soil, and help loosen it up, and that's great. It also holds in moisture. It's wonderful stuff. Anybody can do this, and it's perfect for the beans. Take a look at these beans. They're just crazy. They survived the frost, but I wanted to bring it out here because I'm really going crazy, aren't I? You'd think I was on speed. No, I'm actually having a really good day because it's just beautiful out here, and I want to do everything at once, but I have to take my time and do it slow. So anyway, take a look at this. All right, come in really close and look what happened to my beans after just one rain and now that it's warm outside. Those of you that followed me, you know I planted way too many bean seeds. Oh yes, you're supposed to plant them so far apart. I never do that. I always plant too much. I'm guilty of that. And what I do is I just pick them out and thin them out. Here's how I weed my beans. These, by the way, are the Landreth stringless beans. Oh, they're good. So I couldn't let these grow so close together. Look at this, I got 5 coming out of one area. That's stupid. No, you can't let that grow because they're going to choke each other out. So what I'm going to do is gently pull these out. I know it looks kind of mean. And you toss this back in there and leave these together. There's going to be a gap over here and there's a gap over here and then here's some more. Pull these out. I like to leave an area no less than one hand width between my beans, and that way it gives their roots room to spread out and it gives the plant room. But if it's like maybe the width of a hand, they're going to be close enough together to hold each other up, you know, because if you have a bush bean, they make it sound like it's like this little bush. Not in this lifetime. No, these actually get really tall and then they fall over, and that's no good. And so I plant them kind of close together, and that way they hold each other up. So what I do is I just pull out everything in that little area in between them. See, there's that. Take this out, take this out. Seems kind of mean, but you know what? It isn't going to hurt these things, and that's what I do. I come out to the garden and I do this. Oh, no, 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 these aren't going to waste. Nope. What I'm going to do is look at the bottoms of this. See that? Beautiful, huh? What's that look like? Yeah, bean sprouts. These aren't exactly like bean sprouts, but what I do when I pick my beans is I take these inside, I rinse them off, and I snap off the bottom half, and I eat the bottom. They smell, oh, they smell fantastic. You've had bean sprouts, right? Well, what these are is these are bean sprouts plus. They have more smell, more flavor, and I'm assuming more nutrition than just regular anemic looking bean sprouts. I don't eat the leaves. The leaves go to the chicken. Yep, they're definitely going to be good food for that chicken, so nothing in here is going to waste. And anyway, I just wanted to show you that because this is how Ray gets his beans in order, and they're doing fantastic. The warm weather is really kicking them into gear. Look at all this. I got this little lamb's quarter growing in here. Lamb's quarter is good stuff. You know what? You can eat lamb's quarter. Yep, it's good. If anybody doesn't know what lamb's quarter looks like, well, I would say look in my garden, but I'm eating most of it. Here, take a look at this. This is what lamb's quarter is. Yeah, it's absolutely harmless. It's good. It's actually delicious. You can eat this. There are so many things that you can eat that you don't think that you can eat. You know, I'm not going to go grazing on my garden like some kind of a sheep, but that's actually pretty good. I don't know what kind this is, but I know it tastes good, and that's good enough for me. I planted a row of lettuce seeds, and I had so much, and I was so hyper that day, I planted another row right here. So now I got this L-shaped thing of lettuce, and I thin my lettuce just like I do my beans. I basically, with the lettuce, I pull up everything within arm's reach here. No, but I pull up everything in a hand's width, and then I skip it, and I do another hand's width, and that way I have clumps. And you know, you can start your lettuce inside and then do individual little plugs and put them out there. That is a lot of work, and I'm not into doing that kind of work for my lettuce. I just plant a whole bunch of seeds because they're cheap, and then I pick them out. I do them in little clumps like that, and then with each little clump I start pulling out lettuce. And you can take these and just pinch off the roots, and you have, some people call them microgreens, I just call them lettuce. And you toss that with the little bean sprouts, you know, just the little pickings that you have from your garden, and even young clover. Oh, there's an There's a tick on me. Hi, how you doing? I found a tick on my shoulder. I don't know where that thing came from. And some people are really kind of freaked out when they see a tick. I've been doing this for so long, I just take him and go, snap, his head comes off and I throw him away. Yeah, I could feed him to my chickens, but I don't want to get up out of the garden right now. There are ticks out here, but luckily there are no deer ticks. Anyway, back to the garden. I pull out lamb's quarter, you can pull out young dandelions, you can pull out clover, bean sprouts, lettuce, all kinds of fun stuff. Makes a nice fresh salad, and even onions. Green onions coming up all over the place, and I also have my Kelsey's that sprouted, and I just planted the seeds here. I didn't plant them inside this year. I just planted the seeds and they started popping up, so I got Kelsey onions over there. I got my green onions over here. I have my carrots that came up, and they're little too. You want to see them? Take a look. Oh, before I get going, I wanted to show you this, because I planted stuff out here, and I don't know what I planted because nothing came up, and so I'm assuming it just didn't do that well, because if it did that well, I would know what I planted. So this is a big empty area. Oh, I know what this is. Hi! This is some kind of a cabbage, I think. Okay, well, nothing seems to be doing exceptionally well, and if anything doesn't really catch my interest in the next week or so, I'm going to turn this into either strawberries or something else. I really don't know what, but I want to make sure I make good use of the area. Kind of neat. Everything's green and edible, except I don't know what this is. You gotta go. Right here. These little tall, skinny things, those are my Kelsey's. Yep, my Kelsey's came up. There's all kinds of weeds in there, but I'm not really too awful concerned about that. Not right now. Next week, I'll probably get out here and start weeding, but this week, I'm just gonna let them go. Okay, let's go to the left side of the beans. You can't really tell for the weeds, but I'm gonna be weeding. Don't worry, I'll get to it. I have so many things to do with the baby chicks that I sometimes don't get to the weeding, but it doesn't really hurt my garden too awful much. Take a look. Little tiny carrots. Yep, they got their true leaves. I have a whole row of carrots here. And I think they're gonna do good. They came up really quick, and the frost doesn't hurt them at all. Same thing with green onions. See that? It looks like grass. Yep, these are all green onions. And I don't plant them very far apart, because what I like to do, with the young ones especially, is you can just pull these up. Pull them up, rinse them off, smell them when you pull them. Oh, it's a nice, mellow, onion smell, and this will go, like I said, on my little green salad. Yep, my little sprout salad today. I'm gonna have a lot of fresh greens out of the garden. My lettuce, my beans, my onions, a little bit of, spinach is over there too. I see spinach. Check us out, we're just cruising right along. These are the radishes. Yep, the radishes came through just fine. These are a great early season crop. And normally this time of year, back where I used to live, I would just be planting the garden or thinking about planting the garden. And right now, I have radishes. Yep, well, I don't have actual radishes, but I have the radish greens. And you know, you can eat these radish greens. They are good. On the very end of the garden, the north side of the garden, I have my sunflowers. I've been weeding these out because these came through thick, really thick. And with all the wind that's been coming through, I'm thinking the wind is going to strengthen up those stems. You know how people say put a fan in front of your plants and it'll help strengthen the stems? Holy cow, with the wind I have here, these things are going to be strong if they can survive the wind without falling over. Ew, starting to smell like manure. And that's actually a good thing when it comes to grass compost. Yep, this is grass compost. This is the compost that nobody said would work. I made compost out of nothing but mowed grass. Nothing but mowed grass, and people are like, no, you can't do that. It'll turn anaerobic, it'll stink, it'll get mushy, it'll get blah. You know, they just kept talking and talking and talking. Thing is, it made some of the best compost I've ever had, and yep, it's warm in here. This is just from a mowed lawn. What I'm gonna do this year is I'm gonna make compost out of this, and then I'm gonna take this and make compost tea, because I don't have any compost. I used it all for the garden, so what am I gonna feed my garden? I have to make some compost really, really quick. Grass compost is the fastest way I know of to make compost for your garden. And so it's very, very functional. Your lawn can work so hard for you in your garden. You can either use it for mulch, you can just pile it up and let the worms come up and eat it, and that is a magic thing. Or you can make compost out of it, make compost tea, use the compost in your garden. You can do a lot of stuff with nothing but something that people think is so totally worthless. Think outside the box, folks. Think outside the box. Okay, I got to get going. I'm going to go out there and pick some more beans because I'm kind of hungry, and Rascal wants to go out and play. Thank you for joining me in the garden for the first update. I really do appreciate it. I hope your garden is doing good. If it is, let me know. If it isn't, ask me some questions and maybe I can help. Have a great day, everybody. Bye. Hey, crackhead, let's go.